Hi and welcome back. It's Vicky here with Create8, where I will be creating 8 cars using products from the August release by My Favorite Things. For the first card, I will be using painted poppies. This is an absolute favorite from this release, and I know you will have lots of fun if you love coloring images. You can use your favorite coloring medium to color those poppies. I will be using my Zig Clean markers, and I'm working on a Bristol paper. I won't be using any color for my poppies. I'm just blending those two colors that I picked up, a red and a brown one, directly on my paper. Now, for the first technique, you can see that I have added the darker color on the side of my glass mat, and I'm picking up with a lighter color. And another technique is to directly apply the darker color at the base of each petal and then blend it out with your lighter color. Now, I will be doing these techniques again and again to color all the poppies identically for each and every petal. I also stamped and colored stems and leaves, and then I cut out everything with the matching dies. I also used one of the new dies. These are the large rectangle shaker window and frame to cut out a window. I'm not going for a shaker cut this time. I just wanted to have this window where I can nest inside the stems and the leaves of my poppies. So I'm using white glue at the back of my stems, and I'm actually working with Nouveau Deluxe. And then I'm going to stick down the flowers, this time with foam tape, so I have some added dimension. My sentiment is from this stamp set, which is called From Me to You, and I picked the one that says with my sincere thanks. I am now going to stick down the leaf, and I'm adding white glue at the bottom, which I'm going to tuck inside the frame, and then I have some foam squares at the top of the leaf for added dimension. Now I'm going to finish off my card by adding some black dots with black ebony by Crystal Drops, and my card is finished. For the next card, I'm going to use the Puzzle Cover-Up die. This is from the August release as well. You can see that it's going to cover up your card front. I went ahead and cut out a few of those puzzle pieces from pattern paper, and I picked up different colors that match nicely together. I'm adding foam square at the back, and I'm going to stick down 3 of them connected, and one of them is going to be dropped a little bit off, as if it is missing from the puzzle. And the idea here is to create a miss you card, which is a clean and simple, that you can send to both a male or a female. So here I'm adding glue at the back of this piece, and this is going to lay completely flat. And now I have used the Miss You die. This is a 3×60 from My Favorite Things. I'm using white glue at the back, and I'm going to stick it down. Now, I don't know if you can tell from the video, but these are quite thick, so they have enough dimension to stand out. And that's just because I cut out the word many times out of white cardstock, and I stuck one on top of the other. So it's like chipboard at the moment. Now I'm going to stick everything down. And my card is finished, nice and simple, but really cute. For the next card, I'm going to use the Rolled Rose and the Grand Greenery dies, and I'm going to play with felt today. So I have grabbed my heat gun by Sizzix. I'm going to place it aside and let it warm. And I have picked a few colors of felt, which I'm going to run through the Sizzix machine with my dies. Now, I wanted you to see that these thin dies really cut out felt beautifully. And I'm going to run it once, and it should be cut out, but out of habit, I always like to run it twice. So I'm going to peel off the rose. And then I went ahead and cut out a few more roses as well as a few leaves. And I'm going to put this rose together. This is going to be quite dimensional. So I'm using my tweezers and starting to roll from the end of this die cut all the way to the center. It is really easy when you use your tweezers. Just make sure that the bottom line is completely flat. When you reach the end, just add some white glue, or in my case, my new glue gun, and I was trying to find an opportunity to use that. The glue gun I'm using is by Sizzix. It's a brand new product, and I have unboxed it in a previous video, but I like that there are those silicone finger cups available, so you don't get any finger burns. And I also love the tip of this glue gun because it's really fine. Now, I have prepared all my flowers and all my leaves. I'm working on a panel, and I'm going to stamp my sentiment, which is also from the new stamp set, which is packed with sentiments, that's called From Me to You. And I went with the sentiment that says From Me to You on your birthday. So this is going to be a quite dimensional card, as you can see. I'm sticking everything down with my glue gun. And I'm not planning to mail this card since it's so thick. When I make such dimensional cards, I always like to hand them out to close friends and family that live close by on their birthdays along with their present. So now I'm going to tuck those leaves underneath the flowers. I used white pearls for the center of my flowers, and I mounted this white panel on top of a blue card base that matched perfectly the color of my leaves. Now this is the frightfully sweet, super adorable stamp set from the latest release. And for my card, I will be using the little bunny, which is fully dressed up for Halloween. I am using my Prismacolor pencils to color everything, and I'm working on Bristol paper. I'm going to keep my bunny pretty much white, but I'm adding touches of oranges and purples to match the Halloween theme. Once I have colored everything, I will use the matching dies to cut out my bunny. And as always, I will have to cut off the part where I am coloring the images, especially for videos where I am sharing 8 cards in one. Otherwise, the video is going to be super long. Now my bunny is all colored and ready to cut out, and I'm also going to cut out a window out of this orange panel. So I have a pouch that fits inside that window, and of course I'm going for a shaker card. I always need to share at least one shaker card when I'm sharing a bunch of cards. So now I'm adding some double-sided tape all along this pouch. I'm going to peel off the backing and then place my window on top, and my pouch is ready in place. Now as my card base, I'm going to use this black cardstock, and I'm going to place on top of it some Halloween mix sequins. These are from Lucy's Little Things, but I got this mix last year and I don't know if it is available still. I'm sure there are more mixes for Halloween cards available in the market. I will make sure to link some below. Now I'm going to place my window on top. At the back, I used double-sided tape around the window as well as white glue, so everything is nicely secured there. Now I'm going to stick my little bunny, and I'm combining white glue as well as foam squares so it is leveled with the window, which is quite raised. Now from the same stamp set, I have already prepared my sentiment that says Happy Halloween, which I have white embossed on a piece of purple cardstock. And I'm going to place it underneath my bunny just to ground it somehow so it doesn't look as if it is floating. And my card is ready. Here's another new stamp set. It's called Fluttering Friends, and I will be using this for my next card. This is one of my favorites, another favorite from this release. I have stamped two of the dragonflies as well as a bunch of the leaves, and I'm going to use my Prismacolors to color everything since I already have them on my craft table from the previous card. Now I went with the blues and yellows for one dragonfly, and with yellows and oranges for the other one. And I used the matching dies to cut out everything once I colored all the images. Now I'm working on my background panel and I'm going to apply some Distress Oxide ink through this stencil. This is from the new release and it is called Captivating Mandala. It is a gorgeous stencil and I think it makes a perfect background. I am using one of the new Distress Oxide ink colors, which is the Tumbled Glass, Nice and Light. And it's going to provide the perfect background for my dragonflies. I'm going to decide where everything is going to go and then stick everything down. And as always, I'm using foam squares for some of my images. And for others, I'm going to use white glue just to have some dimension. I white embossed my sentiment on a piece of black cardstock. And this sentiment is from the same stamp set as the dragonflies. To finish off my card, I'm going to add a few crystal gems. These are clear gems and they add a touch of sparkle on my card. And here are some photos of the finished card. For the next card, I will be using the Birds of a Feather die set. And I'm going to cut out two of the birds that are facing each other, as well as I'm going to cut out some leaves from a new die set that I used in a previous card, the one with the leaves. I am going for a card which will be suitable for weddings. This is the wedding season and I need lots of them. So I'm going to cut out the leaves from vellum. I cut out the birds from silver cardstock. And now I'm going to work on a white panel to stamp my sentiment. I'm going to stamp it with Versamark ink and then emboss it with silver embossing powder. So everything is going to be quite monochromatic and very elegant. I picked a sentiment from the stamp set, which is called From All of Us, which is packed with sentiments. And I went with the one that says Congratulations from Us. It's going to end up quite shiny and it's going to match perfectly the birds. Now I'm going to put everything together. So I'm working with white glue and I'm going to create a little greenery at the bottom where my birds can nest on top. So at the moment I have a little bit of a gap at the center, which I'm going to fill in later once the birds are in place. I used foam squares at the back of my birds to add some dimension. And now I'm going to add some white glue at those little cutouts, which are actually the wings of my birds. You can leave it as it is, quite simple, but I decided to go ahead and stick them down. And since this is a wedding card, I just have to add a little heart. And now I'm going to finish off my card by adding some greenery where that gap is between those two birds. Just add one more leaf there. I also created my card base out of silver cardstock, which is going to add a lovely border around my panel. I'm going to stick that down. And my card is ready. For my next card, I'm going to use again the Captivating Mandala, but this time in a die form. So from this release, you get the same design into a rubber stamp, which is quite big, into a die, which I'm going to use now, and into a stencil, which I used in a previous card. I cut out the mandala twice from different colored cardstock and now I'm going to use some glue at the back. And this is the large glue pen by Nuvo. I'm going to stick down the yellow one and I will do the same thing with my blue one. I think this is a gorgeous mandala and you can use it to create lovely backgrounds or focal points. Now I'm going to use my scissors to cut off the excess and you can always use the cut off parts to fill in the empty space that you have on your card. I am not going to do that for this card, but it's definitely an option. I have cut out the word smile from a die that has been released previously. I'm using some white glue at the back and I'm going to stick it down. I used the same colored cardstock as the yellow one, so it matches nicely with the elements on my background. To add some sparkle and more interest on my card, I am adding some big gems at the center of my mandala, and I'm also going to add smaller gems at the tips of the design. Now this panel is slightly smaller than a standard card, so I chose to go with the yellow cardstock as my card base, and I'm going to stick this panel on top. This is going to give me a lovely border all around that is going to bring everything together. And for the last card for today, I will be using this stamp set, which is called Cute Cats. I just cannot resist a cat stamp set. But in any case, in this release, there is also a dog stamp set. So it's worth checking it out if you are a dog lover. Now, I am going to stamp three of those cats and I'm going to color them very quickly, very easily. I'm just going to mainly keep them white. I will add some pink on their cheeks and ears, and then I'm going to use the matching dies to cut them out. I have also used a circle die to cut out these three little windows, and I'm going to cover them up at the back by using three different colored cardstock pieces. Now on each and every one of them, I'm going to add that backing. I like how nice and colorful it looks at the front. And now I'm going to put everything together. I'm going to tuck in those cute cats on each window. And I'm adding a tape runner at the bottom of the cats, just where they need to be nicely secured underneath. And then at the top, I have added foam squares, so they are a little bit raised at the top. I have also prepared the sentiment that says happy birthday, which I think it is adorable. I have white embossed it on a piece of black cardstock, which I think it adds a lovely contrasting color, and it is very readable and stands out. And I'm going to finish it off with my Nouveau Drops in three matching colors to the backgrounds of the cats. So here is the green one. I'm going to add a few with my yellow one, and I will finish it off with the blue. I'm going to stick this panel on a standard card size, that's 4.25 by 5.5, and my card is finished. And these were all the cards for today. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget that I always link the products that I used down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. Thank you all so much for watching today, and I'll see you next time.